Hello guys, how are you today? I hope you all are well. My name is Ari and this is Plastic Holic TV. Today we're going to talk about RGM79GM. Let's go.
Guys, let's look at the fact of this Gundam first, then we'll see the info about the kit.
RGM79GM Thunderbolt version. We can watch it in OVA, with Gundam, TV, in movie, Mobile Suit Gundam Thunderbolt December Sky, and Mobile Suit Gundam Thunderbolt Bandit Flower. Including we can read it in manga is Thunderbolt. First seen in 0079 UC, manufacturer Earth Federation and operator Earth Federation Forces, including more Brotherhood. Non-pilot Lou Fleming and Bianca Carlile. In history, the more Brotherhood deploy multiple units in the Thunderbolt sector to reclaim the area from Zeon forces leaving that division. However, most of the units were heavily damaged or destroyed by the guarding MS-06 Zaku 2 Thunderbolt version and MS-09R Rick Doom Thunderbolt version that were armed with big guns. Lou Fleming managed to survive the destruction of his GM Thunderbolt version by ejecting his core block in time. Special equipment and features. Sub arm. A pair of simple manipulators mounted on the GM Thunderbolt version's large backpack. They are articulated and can be used for various purposes such as exchanging energy pack, holding shield, and etc. Core block system. A central located in the torso, it houses the mobile suit's cockpit. Control systems and main power source, the core block can be ejected in case of emergency and transformed into an emergency pod. Armament. Beam spray gun. A simplified version of the beam rifle, the beam spray gun serves as the main weapon of the GM Thunderbolt version. It can use up to 2 beam spray guns. Twin beam rifle. Mounted on the left forearm, this double barrel beam rifle is a smaller version of the one used by FA-78 full armor Gundam Thunderbolt version. The weapon is powered by energy pack used only by the manga version. Shield. A defensive armament. The GM Thunderbolt version can be equipped with 2 of them, one carried by each of the large backpack mounted sub-arms.
So guys, this kit is very interesting and I have no problem building it. One thing that really annoys me is the support of the joint from the shoulder or arm or hand
to the body. It looks shaky and loose, but it's all under control. The articulation is pretty good, and we can make a lot of poses without any significant difficulties. The sticker is very good and makes the kid look attractive. But I got information from some of my friends who didn't get this sticker when they bought it. I don't know exactly what happened, or Bandai issue a different edition maybe. And maybe you all can explain and write it in the comments below. And overall, this kit is fun. So, happy building everybody!
Guys, thank you for watching. I hope you like what you saw. And please, subscribe to this channel. Smash that like button. And I will see you in the next Gunpla Next Action. Bye-bye!